My name is Harvansh and thank you for watching my other videos. So in my last video, I showed you how we can install SQL 2K12 in VMware. And this video, I'm going to show you how you can give the connectivity in your VM, like the internet access and the how you can make it like a static IP. So let's see the first, this is the server what I installed in my the last videos. If you have not watched, just go back and watch the last video. So before going to build, we need to fulfill the few prerequisites that I am going to show here. Okay, so first let me check this IP address, what IP it's taking, cmd, hostname, lab, IP config. It's taking 136 and let me check the whether it's a static IP or dynamic IP. So here it's taking like a dynamic IP and let me fix it like a with the static IP. Dynamic IP is something like which is frequently changing when your machine got reboot and that IP assigned to the some other IP. So if you reboot your machine later, then IP will be the change. So if you are running your lab, so your IP should not be changed. It will be causing an issue. So now we are going to fix this IP as a permanent. And now my question is like how we can fix it. So I'm going to show to you how we can fix that IP address. So first you go to the VM and here is a view and it's a virtual machine editor. So you need to verify which DHCP or the IP range is allocated to your VM. So when you are installing, it's automatically allocated to your VM. So here is a VNet 8 and the net connectivity. So this is the net is like something which is creating a connection between your physical machine and to the virtual machine. If you want a internet access should be there on your VM machine, then you have to follow this IP range. So here is a IP range is defined 192.168.5.0.2 with this subnet mask. Okay. So in between this subnet mask, you can take it the any IP address and the DHCP setting is something like 128 to 254 any of the IP you can get it. So that's why you received it 136 IP here. So 136 is something after this IP address. Where it find? Okay, so it's here. So 128 to 254 IP address you can get. So here is what my VM machine get it automatically 136. It's get it from the DHCP. Okay. So after 128, I can give the any IP address to my this machine. So what I'm giving it now, let me assign the IP address now. So 192.168.5. And after the 128, I can give the any IP like I am giving 135. Default gateway, you can find out here itself like cmd IP config or the default gateway it's get when we was doing the ping. So default gateway is 192.168 and this is the my default gateway 5.2. so this is my default gateway and the DNS something we have to assign, but DNS as of now we don't have because we didn't install. So we can use it 127.0.0.0. okay. And you can remove this IPv6.4. Now it is done. So my IP is fixed. And now let me check out what is the IP address now. IP IP config. Okay, so now my new IP is 135, and let me check the internet access. Okay, so there is something wrong. Let me check out again. Go to the control panel, properties, put it like the DNS preferred 192.168.5.2 only. Let's try the internet connectivity here. Okay, so now my internet is on, so I can access my internet. I was just trying to give here like a default DNS, but as you are in the VM, so your VM will take the DNS same as like a default gateway. So when you are creating your VMs, it automatically having default gateway and the one default DNS. So you can define it here. Now you have your machine ready to access the internet, and you can do the anything in your machine. If internet is not coming again, then you need to follow this process. Go to the setting and remove this adapter and add it again. So you will get the internet access connectivity here itself. Okay, so guys, this part is done, and now your IP got configured, and in the last video only we changed the host name. And now let's move it to the next scenario, how we can install our Active Directory server on this machine. So now, as of now, we are in the workgroup machine. I will show you how to check it. So now we are under the workgroup machine. We don't have any kind of domain. Let's see, we will create one domain for this. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. See you soon in my next video.